This is a 2-week-old oyster toadfish larvae that is still in the egg membrane. Let's put this into motion. First thing you're drawn to is the beating of the heart. And you can see that this has got a 2-chambered heart, which is typical of fish. And then you'll notice the blood vessels, which are concentrated toward the heart, and as they stretch out further, they get finer and finer, smaller and smaller. You can also see the small tail that is still free and it's developing, but it's still contained in the membrane of the egg. There's also a section of oil droplets that have coalesced, and that's forming part of the yolk, which becomes food for the fish as it develops. Here you can see that the heart is a little slowed down. We've reduced the speed so you can see the motion of the heart bumping both chambers and the blood as it's flowing through the veins in that stop action. Coming even closer, you can see the musculature of the heart collects the blood, and then you can see the forcing action through it from one chamber to the next, and as the blood coalesces in from the smaller vessels into the larger veins. You can also see it's developing eye, a very clear donut looking structure right by the heart. Another view. In this view, you can see the tiny blood vessels in the head and the blood flowing through each one in a single file. This is just fascinating. I could look at this all day. You can also see the oil droplets and the developing notochord for the backbone. And this turns into the fish's musculature. And you can even see the little sections where the muscles will become, the tail. And this blood from this tiny heart is flowing completely around the egg and bringing oxygen to the entire egg. Now, this doesn't have gills yet, but the egg obtains oxygen by diffusion through the water. Now, you can also see a small part of membrane on the right-hand side. This is where it was attached to the nest. This type of fish lays a nest. And as we get in closer, you can see each individual blood vessel. The blood continues on around the egg to the backside, splits, and then brings oxygen to the egg yolk. Again, this is going to be food, which supplies energy for the fish to develop. Comes back around and splits again back into small branching veins, which then coalesce back to the beginning. So we've now made a full circumnavigation of a developing oyster toadfish egg. And here's another good shot of the eye. You can see that clear donut-looking structure right by the heart.